And they did it together.
When I finished the race, I looked at those three people as something that I'll carry with me forever.
They overcame inexperience and injuries and the limits of their endurance.
I believe that we all feel indebted to each other as a team. We all definitely felt we are four as one, not one of four, because even, you know, in the really hard situations, we came through smiling.
The engineer, the realtor, the climbing instructor, and the go-go dancer showed the world they conquered the eco challenge.
Three members of Team Kilroy, Linda, Mark, and Greg, had hoped to return and compete in the next Eco Challenge. Their application was rejected because they were told they had less experience than others this time around. They are appealing that decision. You can watch more of this incredible race on Discovery Channel beginning this Sunday.
Still ahead, he works, she works, all to earn extra money. But are they really better off?
This is Uncle Sam's little secret, and he doesn't want me telling it on network television.
Hey, stop cracking up. Don't let your lips chap or dry. Keep them smooth with new Stay Smooth from Almay, the first anti-chap lip color with SPF 25. A cooling anti-chap complex holds moisture in, helps keep chapping out. Cool, baby. SPF 25 protects. Feels so smooth in 20 Stay Smooth colors. Come on, read my lips. They won't chap, crack, or dry. New Stay Smooth anti-chap lip color from Almay.
You never met my big Italian family, but they love you already. So tonight, they'll share with you a fresh salad this big. Then pass around the baby pictures. They'll share baskets of soft garlic breadsticks. Then pass around the baby. What they have, you can have. And that's how the Olive Garden feels. They call it Hospitaliano, which means everything of ours is yours. That's my cousin. She wants to share your dessert. The Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
Does tossing one of these into your tank kill germs? Who knows? Until now. Introducing Lysol Continuous Action Automatic Toilet Cleaner. It not only cleans and deodorizes, it kills germs. No other automatic toilet cleaner kills more. Till you have our word on it, you can't call it clean. Share the bathroom, not the germs. Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner. The clean that helps protect.
She was being stalked, and they couldn't help her.
We made a mistake.
Now, a murder could ruin two cops.
Are you lying now?
No.
From the Emmy-winning best drama, the first of seven all-new episodes. Law & Order, NBC Wednesday. You know who the killer is this week.
I'm afraid I killed.
Even he'll be surprised to find out who wound up in the killing pool. Days of Our Lives, NBC Daytime.
Now the Dateline timeline. All the following events happened during this, the second week of April. Do you know what year it was?
Okay, we've had a problem here.
An explosion crippled Apollo 13. Harry Blackmun was nominated to the Supreme Court.
We do have to make certain concessions to the war. We're 3 miles from the front line. And
yes, but a man can't really savor his martini without an olive, you know?
Donald Sutherland and Elliot Gould were the star cut-ups of MASH.
What's this? Aboard my ship? Shh, don't yell in front of my baby.
A salty captain captured the spirit of TV's Ghost and Mrs. Muir. And the Jackson 5 had a single heading to the top. All right, what year was it? 1968? 1969 or 1970? The answer when Dateline continues.
Tomorrow on NBC Nightly News. Worried about your weight or your parents' weight? A new study says losing weight could actually do more harm than good for older Americans.
Probably the best thing you can do is just maintain your weight, not try to lose it, but don't gain it.
On NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw tomorrow.
So, big date tonight?
Big.
Well, you mean good china and candlesticks big?
I mean 6'6" big, and that's just an estimate.
What are you making? Side of beef?
Too many fat grams.
Then what?
Roasted chicken tenderloins in a mushroom cream sauce.
Cream sauce. Mm-hmm. Thigh master.
Honey, it's Lean Cuisine hearty portions. It's low fat, low calorie, just a lot more.
Ooh, nice belt.
Stouffer's Lean Cuisine. It's not just lean.
It's cuisine.
I'm a cardiologist. I fix people's hearts. No small thing. People, families, are trusting me with their lives. The differences between hospitals and doctors, they mean everything. I'm a heart doctor. And the day I became a heart patient, well, they meant a lot more.
Ask your doctor about cardiac surgery at Union Memorial Hospital.
More live reports tonight on 11 News.
Is another election in the cards for an ousted state senator? Tonight, insiders say Young will run again. Good evening, I'm Rod Daniels.
And I'm Marianne Bannister. We'll have the inside details of a closed-door meeting tonight. Also, it's no place for a child, so why did so many people on the block know a 5-year-old murder victim by name?
New information and also the latest on a city police officer who is facing murder charges. That's tonight at 11.
If you're waiting for a tax refund and owe child support, don't hold your breath. Your child needs your support.
Happy Passover from WBAL TV 11.
So what year was it? Apollo 13 was unlucky. MASH was a smash. And ABC was tops. It all happened the second week of April, 1970.
You and me. Dateline, winner of 5 Edward R. Murrow Awards for Excellence in Broadcast Journalism, continues.
A lot of you will be up late tonight trying to meet tomorrow's tax deadline. A lot more of you may be lying awake tonight worrying how to make the numbers work. Even if you're a two-paycheck family, where does the money go? In fact, you could be working hard trying to get ahead, only to find that you're falling behind. That's what the couple in our next story discovered. And since we told you about them 2 years ago, they've made some big changes in their lifestyle. Here's Lisa Rudolph.
I feel like if I don't pray before I start my day...
Stop it, both of you.
God help me.
Push. Thank you very much.
Okay, I've got to have all this done before I go to work at 3.
Watch. I think we both run the fast track. Sometimes it feels like we're just running circles.
Julia and Tony Ingram of Lawrence, Kansas are in a daily race.
I'm a line worker. I work for Sprint.
It seems the only way they can get ahead is if both work.
I'm in the bottom assembly of a production. We make the garage door panels.
Two jobs, two kids, no time. Tony, 29, works days. Julia, 26, works nights. In between, they juggle their two young sons and their sanity.
Are we really willing to let her work nights, miss time with the kids, I work days, spend just the weekends together? And basically, the decision was yes, this isn't important enough to us to do that.
Because?
Because we want our children to have the best.
Although Julia would rather stay home with 4-year-old Cole and 2-year-old Joshua, the Ingrams say they need two incomes if they want to someday own a home and send their sons to college.
You want the American dream.
Yeah, exactly. Unfortunately, every time we get closer to the American dream, it changes. It changes. It takes a little bit more money and a little bit harder work and a little more income and a little more shuffle to get there, I think.
And for the Ingrams, the two incomes are better than one shuffle, has Tony earning over $28,000 a year and Julia just under $15,000. Together, they make $43,000. That's about $10,000 more than the median family income in the U.S., and they need every penny.
I couldn't see how money would be set aside for the boys or anything like that. You know, when you look at all the bills and everything that costs you just to live every day.
you may be surprised, as we were, to find out just where all their running is or isn't getting them. In the meantime, the race goes on. Tony rises at 5:30, grabs a quick workout, dresses, and while Julia and the kids sleep, drives 25 miles to his job. 9 a.m., Tony's been at work an hour and a half.
Hey, you.
Julia and the kids are just getting up and making breakfast. They get dressed and head out for errands, rush back for lunch, and then Julia drops the boys off at her mother's while she goes to work at 3:30. A half hour later, Tony's shift ends. He drives back to Lawrence, checks messages and mail, drives crosstown to pick up the kids, and home again. At 6:30, Julia's on the assembly line and Tony's fixing dinner. Then it's playtime, baths, and off to bed while Tony cleans up the house.
And then generally I sit down around 11, 11:30 for some quiet time.
Julia still has 2 hours more on the job. She finally gets home at 2 a.m., hours after Tony has gone to sleep.
I didn't hear any point where you see each other.
We don't see each other.
Mommy.
In fact, the only communication Tony and Julia have during the work week is a couple quick phone calls a day.
Give her a kiss.
And written messages they call honey notes.
Realistically, how long do you think you can keep this kind of schedule, this kind of running up?
As long as it takes. I think we both accepted that it stinks, but we all make sacrifices. This is a sacrifice that we both said we're willing to make.
If this sounds an awful lot like your life, you're not alone. Millions of American families have made the decision to have both parents work. They figure all the stress, exhaustion, and non-existent family time has got to be worth it. But is it?
There are a lot of couples out there just stirring the money around like Tony and Julia and not realizing that it's all coming in, but it's all going out.
Linda Kelly, a home economist, is author of Two Incomes and Still Broke. She studied the finances of the Ingrams and other families who can't understand why they're working so hard with so little to show for it.
And for all the people believing that both spouses need to work to stay ahead, to make more money, not true?
Not in all cases. Most second incomes do clear a profit, but usually it's not nearly as much as expected. And there are some people who even go in the hole because of a second income.
They lose money.
They lose money.
By working a second job.
Their expenses add up to more than their income. It's when both partners work full-time that the costs just explode.
Now remember, Tony was working first and earns more than Julia, who's gone back to work after having the kids. This makes her the second incomer. She's earning $15,000 a year. But how much is she really adding to the family income? Kelly analyzed that for the Ingrams. First, the T word.
Everyone knows they pay taxes. They just don't realize at what rate.
Even though there are two wage earners, deductions and exemptions, such as dependents, mortgage interest, and charitable donations, can only be taken once.
This is Uncle Sam's little secret, and he doesn't want me telling it on network television. He's very fond of second incomers because his take on their paychecks is so large.
Your taxes on your income, $3,900. It's almost $4,000.
Yikes.
I mean, that's more than a quarter of what you earn.
So of Julia's $15,000, $3,900 is already gone. Then there's work clothes, including two pairs of steel-toed boots and safety glasses, $750.
Yeah, I was doing that.
For childcare, even though the Ingrams get a break because Julia's mother helps out, they still give her money to cover food and other expenses. That's $1,000. Then there's Julia's commuting to work and all those trips back and forth to her mother's, $1,250. Eating out, with both working, there's no time to prepare meals. Tony buys breakfast and lunch. Julia buys sandwiches and coffee at work. That's $1,550. And weekends, Julia would rather spend time with the family than cook. That's another $1,000.
rush shopping?
Yeah, I thought it was all rush.
I thought rush started the first sentence of everything we say.
Kelly says many expenses come from rush shopping and buying higher-priced convenience items. The Ingrams have no time to clip coupons or shop around for bargains, whether it's food, clothes, appliances, or insurance.
Stop.
That's $3,900. Then there's the services they pay for they could do themselves, like haircuts that Julia would have time to do if she weren't working, $500. And car maintenance and repairs Tony would do if he weren't watching the boys every evening, another $1,000. And then there's the mommy and daddy can't be with you, so here's a new toy, $500 more.
Hi, bud.
Other expenses, including overtime, Tony turns down because he has to take care of the boys, $750. And the final irony, because both are working so hard they don't have time to keep track of the family finances, they're going to buy a computer, $2,500. And guess what?
Are you saying the Ingrams would have more money if Julia stayed home and didn't work at all?
At this point in their lives, yes.
You ready for the grand total?
Not really, but...
And no one was more surprised than the Ingrams to hear how much it was costing Julia to go to work.
$18,600.
Oh, my gosh.
You make $15,000. That means you're in the hole $3,600 by the time
living
the year's over.
Living this crazy life.
Did you have any idea?
No.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Such an emotional thing to deal with, all the running around and stuff, and then to find out that it's not even benefiting you.
Your best choice, Julia, is to quit work. It really is.
So we asked Linda Kelly to meet with the Ingrams. She said the good news was that for now they'd be better off if Julia stayed home with the children, which she'd rather do anyway, but that she'd have to become a tightwad with the family's wallet. She also suggested Julia babysit at home, find a part-time job, or go to college to get a better job in the future.
For couples who watch this and say, okay, one of us quits work and stays home and we'll come out ahead, is it that simple?
I'm not recommending that everyone run out and quit their jobs. You've got to run the numbers and see just exactly how much you're clearing. It's not how much you make, but how much you keep.
What about people that work because they love it?
Of course, and lots of us do. But we still need to know what our paycheck's doing for us or to us. We need to know the real value of that paycheck so that we don't go out and overspend, no matter how high your income is or how low your income is.
The Ingrams took some of Linda Kelly's advice, but not right away. Soon after their meeting, Julia found out she was pregnant with their third child. She continued working to keep her medical benefits, but quit 2 days before their daughter Jocelyn was born. Since then, she's been home and happy.
My life isn't run here, run there, run here, run there, you know, trying to get everything done, not feeling like I had a family.
But life's still very hectic. To bring in extra cash, Julia now babysits for other children in addition to her own, which every parent knows can be exhausting but rewarding.
It's a lot more gratifying doing it with the work being with your children and other people's children than going out and doing something else that has nothing to do with the thing I love the most, and that's my kids.
By being home, the biggest financial bonanza is the money Tony is now able to earn by working overtime, something he couldn't do when Julia was working outside the house. Putting in just 6 extra hours a week brings in an additional $5,800 a year. That will help them buy their first house. But the biggest dividend is the increased family time.
I don't have to answer him why mom's working tonight. It was the best decision we ever made.
See you later.
Julia expects to clear about $5,000 from babysitting this year. Two Incomes and Still Broke in paperback is expected in the bookstores later this month. And to find out if your family's second paycheck is generating as much income as you thought, you can also check our website. That's at www.dateline.msnbc.com.
Coming up next, her son was killed by a friend who was playing with a gun.
And then you go to bed crying, and then you wake up in the morning and you think, it's morning, but I don't really want to get up.
Can a new smart gun help save lives? It's a Dateline discovery.
New Quaker fruit and oatmeal cereal bars. The tastiest fruit and the goodness of Quaker oatmeal make one great taste. So good, those apples just had to get in on the act to make their own fruit-filled, golden-baked taste sensation. New Quaker fruit and oatmeal bars, where the goodness of Quaker oatmeal meets the tastiest fruit.
The Comfort Collection from Ethan Allen. Comfortably priced sofas and chairs. Custom upholstery that's at home, even if your house is a zoo. The Comfort Collection from Ethan Allen, where everyone's at home. The spring sale is on now.
You thought it was over with, but you're still smoking. You keep trying to quit, but you keep lighting up. Zyban can help you look at quitting a whole new way. It's the nicotine in cigarettes that's addictive. It's been proven. And most people need help to quit. Today, there's nicotine-free Zyban. Not a patch, not a gum. Instead, the first pill that is part of a comprehensive program from your doctor can help you quit smoking. Zyban is prescription medicine that can help reduce your urge to smoke and make quitting bearable. It's important to know there's a risk of seizure associated with Zyban. To reduce the risk, don't take Zyban if you've had an eating or seizure disorder or are being treated with Wellbutrin. Don't take Zyban if you're taking an MAO inhibitor. Quitting is tough, and Zyban won't work for everyone. See your doctor or pharmacist for information written especially for patients. Ask your doctor if Zyban is right for you, and break free from nicotine. Break free from smoking.
Later on in All New Tonight Show, something tells me Dennis Franz was the butt of Jay's jokes one time too many. Plus, from Lost in Space, Jack Johnson, Aussie sensation Savage Garden, Ed's Easter egg disaster, and why Jay loves to pay taxes.
So benefits may be extended to the unemployed.
Then Conan's got Patricia Arquette tonight.
In a future world where the government controls everything,
be happy.
Two people have just committed the greatest crime of all.
It makes me feel something that I've never felt before.
They fell in love.
Can't afford this disorder.
They're gonna have to kill me.
Peter Gallagher, Leonard Nimoy, based on the classic novel.
I want love!
Brave New World, Sunday on NBC.
They sit in a juvenile detention center, two young boys charged with a shooting spree in Jonesboro, Arkansas, awaiting a hearing later this month. And the question lingers, could the bloodbath have been prevented? When children pick up guns unsupervised, terrible things can happen. In a single year, 185 kids, all under the age of 14, were killed playing with guns. That's despite gun locks and tough new gun laws. Well, now there may be a way to cut down on at least some of the carnage, both accidental and deliberate. A gun only its owner can fire. Here's Bob McEwen with tonight's Dateline Discovery.
He was adored and he knew it.
These are the only moving pictures of Kenzo Griffin Dix. So full of life, he could have been your friend.
One friend remarked that Kenzo was the most genuine person he knew.
He could have been your brother.
Kenzo made everyone around him feel good.
He was Lynn Dix's youngest son.
For us, he was delightful.
He was just 15 when he died, shot accidentally by a friend who was playing with his own father's gun without permission.
I think I went into immediate shock. I mean, you go to bed crying, and then you wake up in the morning and you think, it's morning, but I don't really want to get up.
Could it have been prevented? What if there were a firearm that would never work in the wrong hands? A gun that would know when to fire. But more importantly, when not to. The weapon in the foreground is a prototype for something called a smart gun, or personalized gun.
As you can see, it looks just like any other firearm. It is a real firearm.
Co-inventor Kevin Kaminsky of Colt Manufacturing helped design it. Here's how it works. A tiny radio transmitter or transponder, the size of a thumbtack, hidden in that watch, sends a signal to a receiver inside the gun, enabling it to fire. No watch, no gunshot.
When the transponder is within range of the firearm, indicated on our first prototype by the flashing light and a beep, the gun is enabled to fire. if the user didn't have a transponder or if the transponder were out of range of the firearm, the gun wouldn't fire.
One of the more recent technologies that was looked at was fingerprint technology.
Wendy Howe works for the federal government's National Institute of Justice, which is researching similar concepts. Because each year, of the police officers killed, 1 in 7 is shot with their own weapon when disarmed by a suspect. This gun is activated by the right fingerprint.
It's actually scanning in your print, verifies it, and it would allow you to fire.
This one uses voice recognition. The password.
Sleepwalking. If you have a confrontation and you're yelling freeze to somebody, you can activate your firearm.
Gun advocates like the National Rifle Association stress that technology should never take the place of training and safety education. And meanwhile, a mother who lost her youngest son only wishes that tomorrow's technology,
he could be alive today,
had been there yesterday.
There are too many deaths by guns, and they are preventable.
Lindix has filed suit against the gun manufacturer, Beretta USA. The lawsuit claims the company was negligent for not taking advantage of technology that could have kept an unauthorized user from firing the gun and might have prevented the death of her son. Beretta has moved to dismiss the case, claiming that the accident occurred because the gun owner did not follow recommended safety procedures, not locking the weapon and keeping the ammunition in a separate location.
Coming up next, food served with conviction on Dateline's Picture of the Week. Dateline will continue after this message from your local station.
Up next, it looks like a political rerun for an ousted state senator. Tonight, insiders say Larry Young will be back. And a city cop stands accused of murder tonight. There's some surprising news about his alleged victim. The latest next.
You know the wonderful feeling of stepping into a freshly clean shower. Now you can get that feeling every day without having to clean your shower again. Because now there's new Tilex Fresh Shower. After your shower, spray a light mist. Don't scrub or even rinse. Tilex Fresh Shower keeps soap scum and mildew from building up, so your shower is always clean and fresh. Try new Tilex Fresh Shower, and you'll never have to clean your shower again.
How's my precious?
You're getting so big.
One plant food gives your plants as much loving care as you do. Osmocoat. One sprinkle feeds your plants continuously, every day, all season long. Osmocoat, the plant food for plant lovers.
The other day, I'm driving down Broadway when that pastrami on rye catches up with me. Heartburn big time. My passenger says, here, take a Zantac 75. I say, what are you, a doctor? And he says, yeah.
The medicine in Zantac 75 is the number one doctor-prescribed acid reducer. It relieves even your toughest heartburn, controlling acid for up to 12 hours.
A real gentleman, that doctor.
Zantac 75, the final word in heartburn relief.
Get revolutionary color.
And make it last.
Revlon Nail Enamel. Up to 7 long days of stay true color, 7 long days of shine. Up to 7 long days of chip resistance without peeling.
This time, Revlon really nailed it.
Revlon.
I never thought when my son moved away that I wouldn't see him for 3 years. It's just a tractor for my grandson. But this trip I wasn't gonna miss.
He's sleeping.
This is for when he's older. My son had built his own life.
Hey, Dad.
He got a John Deere.
Of course.
But he still appreciates where he came from.
The new LT-133 from John Deere. At under $2,000, it's possibly the best lawn tractor ever built. And it's the only one with a past as bright as its future.
And now here's Katie Couric with a look at what's coming up tomorrow on Today. Katie.
Thanks, Jane. With all the excitement surrounding the movie Titanic, it's easy to overlook the real event. On the anniversary of the ship sinking, we'll talk with one of the last remaining survivors of the disaster. Plus, if you haven't filed your taxes yet, we'll have some last-minute advice on how you can get them in on time. That's all coming up tomorrow on Today. Stone?
Now let's take a look at a special hour we're working on for Dateline Friday.
Are they victims of hard times or simply feeding off our tax dollars?
We have started, I think, what is called the welfare revolution in America.
Welfare was my life.
Join us for a special look at the end of welfare as we know it. For a year, Maria Shriver followed four people living its reality. Women forced to go off the dole and back to work. Will they make it?
The story on Dateline Friday.
Finally tonight, you've heard of fancy restaurants that no one can get into. Now comes a restaurant in Japan that's hard to get out of. From Tokyo's Roppongi district, we call our picture of the week, what a joint. As in, what else do you call a place where the maitre d' handcuffs you with the door? But they can't seem to keep throngs of presumably law-abiding diners away from Alcatraz. The new restaurant where serving time has a slightly different meaning. Rations seem pretty good for prison food, and stool pigeons at the bar report that service is, well, watchful. Just don't try to leave without paying the bill. That's all for this edition of Dateline. Join us again for Dateline Friday at 9, 8 Central. Now stay tuned for your local news. I'm Jane Pauley. For all of us at NBC News, good night.
Danger, Will Robinson, Lost in Space's kid Jack Johnson travels to The Tonight Show along with Dennis Franz, plus the soothing sounds of Savage Garden. Your local news is next.